Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about a personal area network, that is a wireless PAN network. At the same time we are also find out the need of PAN network and advantages disadvantage. We also discuss about the various standards of wireless PAN network. So let's begin with the topic. WPAN, that stands for wireless PAN network. It is a PAN network, that means it is a wireless network which is formed in a very short range coverage area. So let's start with the introduction of wireless PAN network. As discussed, the wireless PAN, that is WPAN, are short to very short range wireless network. That means it covers a range of from centimeter to couple of meters. So that means a very short range to a very short range form of network is called as wireless PAN network, which is a personal area network. The WPAN can be used to replace the cable between the computers and their peripheral. So we can say the network form between the computer and the mouse can be a example of PAN network. IEEE 802 has established the IEEE 802.15 WG for wireless PAN as a standard, which standardized protocol and interface for the wireless PAN. So the protocol and the standards you define by IEEE 802 are nothing but IEEE 802.15 WG is considered as a standard for wireless PAN communication purpose. The best example representing wireless PAN is the industry standard Bluetooth, which can be found in any of the consumer electronics. So the communication or the network formed by Bluetooth is considered as an example of the wireless PAN network. Other examples of the wireless technology include IRDA, then the BroadSense, the home RF are the examples of the wireless PAN network. So here figure shows the example of wireless PAN. So that is, the PAN node can be a laptop, it can be a printer, it can be a pager, or any portable device that is connected by using a wireless technology comes under the category of wireless PAN network. Now moving toward the introduction part, as we know there is a lot of development going on in the Bluetooth technology as well as in some other wireless technology. Therefore the wireless PAN network is expanding very rapidly. As people uses more electronic devices at home and at the office, therefore a clear need for wireless connectivity between the devices has been emerged. So as we uses more and more wireless devices, the need of wireless communication is goes on increasing in very rapid manner. The devices that needs to be networked are nothing but the desktop computer, then we can say handheld computer, printer, scanner, pager, etc. So all these devices which basically works on the wireless communication requires formation of wireless PAN network, that is wireless personal area network. Using cable for connecting these devices with the PC and with each other is difficult task and in the stationary location. So when the cable connection is used for connecting these devices to any other devices or for connecting these devices to a PC, then it will put restrictions on the mobility of the user. And therefore it is called as a constraint or drawback of wired communication. And to avoid that, the wireless communication comes into the picture. The wireless communication offers mobility to the user so that the user as well as device can be moved anywhere without having a restriction of wires. If the setup and administration of wireless PAN become a simple and natural in the future for the end user, then most of the scenario of wireless PAN technology is a cable replacement. As the needs goes on increasing for the wireless communication, then and if we allow the simple network administration and simple control of the wireless network, then it is possible that the entire network is get replaced using wireless PAN network. This provides a reason to use wireless PAN network technology and will open door for many advanced applications in future, as there is no constraint of wires or there is no constraint on the mobility of the user. Therefore more and more use of wireless application or more and more use of wireless communication results into many application or many future applications in future. Now there are certain characteristics of wireless PAN network, and the few characteristics are short range communication, as it covers a distance from few centimeters to a couple of meter. Therefore, it provides a very short range or very, very short range. Then low power consumption, as the range is short, therefore the device will not require to consume more power, and therefore it results into low power consumption. Then low cost, the wireless net devices which are available to form a wireless network are having very low cost. Then small personal network, as the range cover is very short, therefore it results into small personal network. Communication of device within a personal space. So a wireless WAN network can be formed within a room also, which it is acts as a personal area or the personal space of the user. So it allows the user to have a personal space network within a home or within an office. So while providing these features of low cost, then short range, and providing users personal space, the wireless WAN is able to achieve two main goals, and the goals are, first of all, broad market acceptability, and second one is the device interoperability. As the need of wireless equipment is going on, as the people purchasing more and more wireless devices, therefore it is possible for the wireless WAN network to expand globally so that people can use it in more and more manner. It is important that the wireless WAN specification addresses the leading devices category that require wireless connectivity in the way that it both easy for implementation and affordable. So we know that to form a wireless network, the device must support the interoperability as well as it must support the affordability to the user and easy implementation to the user. So if the device is able to satisfy these characteristics, then only it is possible for the user to establish a wireless WAN network in a simple manner, and therefore user can use it in more efficient way. At this level, the device manufacturer are willing to incorporate a technology into broad range of the devices for both consumer and business market. So by making the technology more and more simple, it is also possible for the manufacturer to expand the wireless connectivity network globally so that the people can use it in more fashion. Three wireless standards that are leading the way of wireless WAN are nothing but, first of all, IRDA, that is infrared DA. Second is Bluetooth, the most common used wireless WAN network. And third one is IEEE 802.15. Out of these three, Bluetooth is most commonly used and globally expanded or globally accepted wireless WAN network. Each of these standards enables user to connect variety of devices without having to buy, carry or connecting cable. So even if there is a no cable, it is possible to connect the device with each other by using a wireless network, and therefore it will act as a cost saving option for user also. They also provide a way to establish ad hoc network among the mobile devices on the market. So we can form a ad hoc network which is used for the temporary purpose for transmission of data by using a Bluetooth devices. If the 2-3 Bluetooth devices are available in the space, then it is possible to form a network within these devices, and therefore it provides an easy option of data transfer to the user. Now, after having a short introduction about the wireless WAN network, now let's move on to why there is a need of wireless WAN network, why people use this for the communication purpose. So let's understand the need of wireless WAN network. The concept of personal area network was first demonstrated by IBM researcher in 1996 that utilized human body to exchange the digital information. So in 1996, IBM scientists worked on the human body for transmission of the digital signal, and there the concept of personal area network comes into the picture. IBM engineers created a way to communicate between the body brawn appliances by using the human body as a channel, with only limitation of some form of human contact between the devices is required, which may not always desirable or possible. So transfer of data or transfer of any information by using a human body is not always possible, and it is not always desirable. So to overcome this problem of human contact, because without human contact it is not possible to exchange the data, so they put a limitation on a transmission of data. So to avoid this or to overcome this drawback, another alternative such as infrared or far field, that means a radio communication, have been considered using wireless methods such as IR and radio frequency for PAR. So rather than using human body as a medium of transfer, the scientists used infrared, and they use a radio signal, that means the RF signal, for transmission of data or as a communication channel. The wireless LAN devices are typically smaller, operates on a battery power, and either worn or human body or carried personally. So as we know, just for the example, the mobile phones containing Bluetooth, and they are operated on battery. They are smaller in size as well as they can easily carried by human being. So the Bluetooth devices, or we can say the VPAN or the wireless LAN devices, are smaller in size. They are operate on the battery and they carried personally. The main design goal of wireless LAN is to allow device that are close proximity to communicate and exchange information with each other, either stationary or moving. Even if the object is stationary or even if the object is moving, and if it is in the proximity or in the area of the wireless LAN network, then it is possible to perform the exchange of data without having a wired connection or without having any type of connection between the devices. Wireless LAN functions similarly to the wireless LAN, while differ in terms of power consumption, coverage area, data rate, and cost. So when we compare a wireless LAN network and wireless LAN network, there is no difference in the functionality of the network. The only difference is in the terms of data transfer, then it is in the terms of coverage area, it is in the terms of power consumption and cost. The wireless LAN network is nothing but the home network, or we can say the network which covers a building or network which covers a small office. The wireless LAN can also consider as a network within home or a network within office, but it provides a very short coverage area as compared to wireless LAN. Also, the cost of wireless LAN equipment are less as compared to wireless LAN equipment, and the data rate provided by wireless LAN is more as compared to wireless LAN. So on this basis, the two networks are get differentiated from each other, but functionally they work as same network. The wireless LAN should allow devices to create or provide data, voice access point, personal ad hoc connectivity, and be a replacement for having connecting cable. So basically, the wireless LAN is get created in order to transmit the data, which may be in the form of audio and video signal. Then it provides the ad hoc connectivity, that means a temporary connectivity. Loss of connectivity or adding any node to the network do not affect the entire network performance. So that is called as ad hoc connectivity. At the same time, it provides an option which acts as a replacement for the connecting cables. The operating range for these devices is within a personal operating space, which is called as POS, of up to 10 meters in all the direction, and envelops a stationary or mobile person. So the operating range provided by the wireless LAN devices must cover the personal operating space, which having a range up to 10 meter, and it must cover the devices which are present in that range, as well as it covers a mobile person or the any stationary object. The concept of POS, that is personal space object, can be extended to a devices such as printer, scanner, digital camera, microwave oven, TV, VCR, etc. So the LAN devices can be any devices which comes under the personal space of the user. It varies from a mobile phone device to TV, microwave oven, then digital camera, or any device that can be connected wirelessly to the wireless LAN devices. The LAN system are expected to provide a secure mode of operation, allowing group of personal devices to interconnect while excluding connectivity to other non-essential devices. So while performing a wireless communication, security is considered as one of the most important concern, and therefore the wireless LAN system are expected to provide a great, or it should provide a proper security to the wireless communication, so that the device can communicate only to the intended device and not to the other devices which are not required to part of the communication. They should not affect the primary function, the form factor, power consumption of the device in which they are embedded. The wireless LAN, as it uses a license-free radio frequency, that is ISM band, that is having value of 2.4 GHz, they have to coexist with other technologies which and make the use of this frequency. So as the wireless LAN network uses a wireless communication, that means a frequency band of 2.4 GHz range, which is also called as IMS band, industrial, scientific, and medical band, which is license free. So anyone can use this band without having the actual permission or without having a special permission. So while operating on this band, the While operating on these band, the wireless PAN should take care of the interferences from the other frequency or interferences from other devices, and they should cooperate, or they should provide the operability with the other frequencies or other technology which operates on the same frequency range. So because of this, there is a need of wireless PAN network, as it provides a low cost option and as it provides a no constraint on the user mobility. Therefore, it is possible for the user to connect to any device. So this specifies the need of wireless PAN network. Now let's move on to the various standards used by wireless PAN network. The many standards available for the personal area network, the each standard having its own weakness and own advantages, and because of which it is possible to make some standard in some application. Every application requires some unique standard to be used based on the weakness and strength of that particular standard. In some cases, more than one technology will be able to perform the required task. Hence, non-technical factors such as cost, availability will factor into the decision as which technology is more appropriate. It is not necessary that any application uses only one technology or one standard for its operation. More than one technology or more than one standard can also be used to develop or to implement any application. At the same time, the cost, then availability of the wireless PAN devices, availability of the network also makes an important role in developing the wireless PAN network or in deciding which standard or which technology to be used for development of the wireless PAN network. So this is what about the wireless standard. Now let's move on to the various standards used by wireless PAN network. The most commonly used three standards are nothing but IRDA, then second is Bluetooth, and third one is IEEE 802.15. So now let's discuss this standard in detail one by one. So the first standard is IRDA, which is an international organization that creates and promotes interoperable low-cost infrared data connection standard. As its name indicates, it stands for Infrared Data Association. It is basically an international organization which provides a standard for low cost and low power consumption data communication by using the infrared. IRDA has a set of protocols to support broad range of appliances, computers, and communication devices. These protocols are typically aimed at providing high speed, short range, line of sight, and point to point wireless data transfer. So by using IRDA, it is possible to perform a point to point connection between the devices with high speed and within a short range of operation. IRDA protocol uses IRDA data as a data delivery mechanism and IRDA control for controlling mechanism. For the data transfer, IRDA uses IRDA data, and for controlling mechanism, it uses IRDA control command for performing the control on entire operation of the network. Basically, the original goal of IRDA is to provide a cable replacement technology, which because of which it is possible to use a wireless communication or wireless medium in an efficient way. The idea was that the two computers could communicate simply by pointing them at each other. For example, to print a document, we require to simply point the infrared port at the printer and therefore able to send data to the printer. So by using the infrared rays or by using the infrared light, it is possible to perform a communication between the two PCs, and that basically the concept of IRDA. No cable is required for the data transfer. Then technically, infrared technology is well suited for such type of tasks. So whenever we want to perform a data communication between computer and printer or between the two computers, then we can use the infrared, that is IRDA, for communication purpose. Now let's discuss some features provided by IRDA. The communication range is up to 1 meter, although the distance of 2 meter can also be reached by using the repeaters and any or other devices. Low power option for communication up to 20 centimeter. This requires 10 times less power than the full power implementation. Then the bidirectional communication, that means it is possible to transmit as well as receive the data in both the direction. The data transmission from 9600 bps up to maximum speed of 4 mbps. So the data transfer speed range is nothing but having minimum value of 9600 bits per second to up to 4 mbps. So using IR, that means using infrared for transmission of data, is actually a great idea. But when it comes to a practical, it becomes quite difficult because of many reasons. This may be a technical challenge during earlier representation because it requires a line of sight for performing data transfer. Therefore, it puts a restriction on the operation of the network. For IR network to work, a communicating device must have to maintain a line of sight. If the device is not in line of sight, then it is not possible to perform a data transmission, or it is not possible to perform a data reception. They have to situate it within an operating range, typically 2 meter range, point at each other, and have no physical obstacle. If there is any obstacle present in between them, then also it is not possible to perform the operation successfully. So within a range with a line of sight, the IRDA communication can take place. So this somehow put a restriction on the operation, or this somehow put restrictions on the user mobility. So because of which IRDA is not that much popular as compared to other standards. So in some of the office environment, this limitation is not practical. In case of printer and scanner, we can perform the IRDA, or we can use IRDA for performing data transfer between printer and scanner without any obstacle and within the range of 2 meter. So using infrared to transfer data between two nodes is more realistic. Two devices, user can use infrared to transfer information such as electronic business card between one another. There are some areas where the infrared is frequently used. So if the application satisfied the requirement of the IRDA, that means line of sight and the range requirement, then it is possible to use it in any of the application. One of the application is nothing but the electronic business card reading, and the second one is communication between PC and printer, communication between PC and scanner without any obstacle. The IRDA control standard allows wireless peripherals such as keyboard, mouse, then gamepad, joystick, etc. to interact wirelessly with the host device, very often desktop and PC unit. In gaming application also, we can use the IRDA for performing the IRDA control, in which there is no restriction on the mobility of the user and there will be no obstacle present in between the transmitter and receiver. Therefore, it is possible to control, or it is possible to perform the network operation in an efficient way. The host device can communicate with up to 8 peripherals simultaneously. So maximum 8 devices can be connected to the host device, or that means the transmitter or receiver to which we want to perform the communication. The data transfer rate for IRDA control typically reaches 75 kbps, which is enough for data to be transmitted between the different types of devices. Now, apart from the disadvantage, or we can say apart from the restriction, there are still advantages provided by IRDA, and the advantages are: IRDA from a device manufacturer perspective is a cost. IR port can be incorporated into a device as low as $1. This is very low cost for implementing the wireless communication into a device compared to otherless wireless PAN standards. So low cost is considered as a major advantage provided by the IRDA system. So because of which it is possible to use the IRDA in most of the application rather than by using some other wireless personal area network standard. The another wireless PAN standard that is used for the communication is nothing but the most well-known standard, that is nothing but Bluetooth. So basically, Bluetooth is a standard for enabling wireless communication between the mobile computers, between the mobile phones and any other portable device which is having a Bluetooth facility in it. Now, not similar to IR, Bluetooth does not require line of sight, and this overcomes the limitation or drawback of IR. Bluetooth can be connected anywhere at any place without having the actual line of sight with the other device, which was acts as a restriction or drawback in case of IR. It is able to communicate through a physical batteries, typically having a range of 10 meter, and with a power amplifier, the range can be extended up to 100 meter. So basically, Bluetooth provides a range of 10 meter, and if you use a power amplifier for boosting the signal, then the range can be increases up to 100 meter. Bluetooth also operates on the unlicensed frequency range, that is 2.4 GHz spectrum, for communication with the maximum data transfer speed of 720 kbps. It is expected that this throughput will increase around 10 mbps with the future Bluetooth specification. So as the future development is going on, the data rate provided by Bluetooth is also get increased. The origin of Bluetooth is date back to 1994, where Ericsson was researching ways to enable mobile phone to communicate with the peripheral. So in 1994, so Bluetooth was first originated in 1994, where the company finds a need in order to have a communication between the mobile devices without using a wired connection. So 4 years later, that means after 1994, 4 years later, in 1998, Ericsson's along with Nokia, Intel, Toshiba, and IBM form a Bluetooth special interest group, which is called as SIG, for defining a specification for small form factor, low cost wireless communication. Since then, 3Com, Lucent, Microsoft, and Motorola have joined the Bluetooth SIG as a Bluetooth promoter. So this is what about the history of Bluetooth, that is when it is originated, then how it is get evolved. So it was originated in 1994 by Ericsson because of the need of connecting the mobile phone without using a wire connection. Then in 4 years later, in 1998, the various companies like Motorola, then Microsoft comes together and they form a group that is called as SIG. After that, the various companies like 3Com, Microsoft, Lucent join SGI in order to promote the Bluetooth. Now, in addition, over 2000 companies have joined the SIG Bluetooth as a Bluetooth adopter and associate member. As there is no limitation on line of sight, or we can say as line of sight is not required for the communication purpose, the Bluetooth device to interact with each other is a travel. So naturally, they interact with each other without having any line of sight restriction. Bluetooth provides an auto-discoverable mode where Bluetooth device will automatically discover other devices which are present within the range. So when we turn, which usually when we turn on the Bluetooth and if we make the device discoverable, then it automatically detects the other Bluetooth enabled devices in that particular range of Bluetooth. Once they detect it, they start communication. So after detecting, if we permit the device to perform a communication, then only it is possible to perform a communication with the Bluetooth device. So basically, as it is a wireless communication, the permission is required from the user for providing security for the data transfer. There is some concern that this will overload the 2.4 GHz spectrum as more Bluetooth devices becomes available. So as the need of wireless communication is going on, more and more devices form a network, or more and more devices uses a spectrum of 2.4 GHz as it is a free spectrum. So because of that, it is possible that the 2.4 GHz spectrum becomes get overcrowded due to the use of various wireless technologies. So in order to address this issue, or in order to overcome this issue, Bluetooth specifications get defined three different modes. First is generally discoverable mode, second is limited discoverable mode, and third is non-discoverable mode. So let's understand this mode in detail. So first is generally discoverable mode. This allows Bluetooth device to be detected by any other Bluetooth device within its proximity. So if there are two Bluetooth devices, Bluetooth enabled devices are present, and then any of the device can detect each other which are in the close proximity of that particular Bluetooth range. Then second is limited discoverable mode. Only well-defined devices will be able to detect the device in this mode. This mode will used when the user has many Bluetooth devices and wants them to discoverable each other automatically. So it is basically the depend upon user to which device it wants his device to make discoverable, and that is called as limited discoverable mode. And third is nothing but non-discoverable mode. This makes the device invisible to other device, but it cannot get detected, because of which it is cannot get detected. As the name indicates, non-discoverable, therefore it is not discoverable by any other Bluetooth device. When two or more than two devices connect, they simply form a piconet, which is ad hoc network that can consist of maximum 8 devices. So basically, piconet is a network which is formed by two or more than two Bluetooth enabled devices, and maximum we can connect 8 devices to form one piconet. Every device in the piconet can communicate directly with the other devices. There is no centralized architecture sort of thing present in case of Bluetooth. As it is an ad hoc network, therefore any device can communicate with any other device as it uses decentralized architecture. It is also possible to have a network with more than 8 devices. In this case, several piconets can be combined together to form a scatter net. So when more than 8 devices are present, then what happens? Each 8 device forms a piconet, and when one or more than one piconet together perform a communication, then it forms one scatter net. In scatternet configuration, not all devices can see each other. Only the device within each piconet are able to communicate. So it is not possible that even if it is a scattered net, even if it is uses the same technology, then it is not possible for all the devices to discoverable each other. Only the devices within each piconet can communicate with each other. For example, if we consider two piconet, then it is not possible for piconet one device to get discoverable to piconet two device, but they can communicate with all the devices with the piconet one. So now figure shows the Bluetooth with the scattered net having the 5 piconet. So here, this considered as one piconet which uses 3 laptop and 1 access point. This is considered as one piconet and this is considered as one piconet. So they form together a scattered net. So now in the figure, one scattered net consists of 5 piconet. The hands-free mobile phone is a member of 3 different piconets and it is able to communicate directly with the handset, the Bluetooth pin and the access point, but it is not able to communicate directly with the laptop, computer and fax machine. So moving back to the diagram, the hands-free and the mobile phone can communicate with each other, but the Bluetooth pin can communicate, but it is not possible for the Bluetooth pin to directly communicate with the laptop, printer and scanner or fax machine. It will communicate with the access point. So as the requirement of the wireless communication is going on, the number of Bluetooth devices on the market is also growing every day. And it is common for the mobile phone, it is common for the PDA, laptop, peripheral to come and equip with the mobile chip. So in all the devices which are wireless used, wireless communication, they are enabled with the Bluetooth model in it. It has been made possible by the lowered cost of the Bluetooth chipset. The main reason for growing demand of the Bluetooth communication is nothing but the low cost of Bluetooth chipset. The user are now aware of many compiling features that Bluetooth offers. Some of the features of Bluetooth is nothing but the first important is cable replacement. There is no need of cable to connect two devices for the communication. By using a RF signal or by using a radio signal, it is possible to perform a communication with each other. Therefore, there is no need of cable. Then mobile device networking, then global ad hoc network, then it supports both voice as well as data communication and worldwide vendor and product support. So because of this feature, Bluetooth is gaining more and more popularity in the today's market. Now the next wireless personal area network standard is nothing but 802.15 and it is specified by IEEE, which stands for Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineer, and it develops a standard for short range wireless network or wireless personal area network. Now it has the same goal as Bluetooth, that it took to address the wireless network of portable and mobile computing devices such as PC, PDA, mobile phone, peripheral devices and consumer electronics. Now it is basically established in 1999 as a part of Local Area and Metropolitan Area Network Standard Committee of IEEE. So the main goal of the 802.15 network or 802.15 standard is to provide a short range wireless communication between the devices, which may be a PC, it may be a laptop, PDA, mobile phone or any other device which are Bluetooth enabled device or which are unable to communicate using a wireless technology. So in 1999, that means at the time of establishment, 802.15 wireless PAN network working group was aware of Bluetooth specification and used part of it as a foundation for 802.15 standard. So we can say that 802.15 is derived from Bluetooth standard, because at the time of establishment, the people who are working on it know about the Bluetooth specification and standard, and therefore they uses the same thing for the development of 802.15 standard. The 802.15 wireless specification is aimed at standardizing the media access control and physical layer of the Bluetooth in attempt to accommodate wider option or wider adaptation of short range wireless technology. So it basically focuses on the physical layer and the MAC layer of the Bluetooth layered architecture so that it can have the more popularity and it can adopt the more short range wireless technology. 802.15 also deals with the issue like coexistence and interoperability within the network. So to accomplish this goal, 4 task groups have been established, each working on the specific component of the 802.15 specification, and the 4 task groups are: first one is 802.15 wireless PAN network task group 1, which is called as WPAN/Bluetooth. It is called as TG1, that is Task Group 1. It has created the wireless PAN 802.15.1 standard based on the Bluetooth version 1.1 specification. To make this possible, IEEE licensed technology from Bluetooth SIG. Specifically, 802.15.1 defines the MAC and physical specification for the wireless connectivity of the device that are either fixed or portable within the personal computing space. So we can say that the 802.15.1 is a standard which basically is more focused on the physical layer and the MAC layer of the Bluetooth device or MAC layer of the any device which are enabled to perform a wireless communication. The specification also take into consideration coexistence requirement with 802.11 wireless local area network devices. Then the second group is nothing but TG2, that is 802.15 wireless PAN task group 1 coexistence mechanism. So it is basically developing a recommended practice to facilitate the coexistence of wireless PAN, that is 802.15, and wireless LAN technologies. So this group basically focuses on merging, or we can say the existence of wireless LAN as well as wireless PAN network. Part of this task involved developing coexistence model to qualify the mutual interference of the WAN and wireless LAN. Once approved, this outcomes of TG2 work will become IEEE 802.15.2 specification. The next is nothing but TG3, that is stands for 802.15 wireless PAN task group high rate wireless PAN network. So it is basically developed to provide a new standard of high data rate, which varies from 20 Mbps to or more than that wireless PAN network. Now, in addition to the high data rate, the 802.15.3 also provides a mean of low power and low cost solution so that it can fulfill the need of portable consumer electronics and multimedia applications. So, in order to provide the higher data rate within a short range and with a less power consumption and low cost, this group is get created. The next is nothing but group 4, which stands for 802.15 wireless PAN task group 4, that is TG4, which is also called as low rate long battery life. As its name indicates, it is basically developed in order to provide the low cost devices but to provide a long battery life, that means less power consumption in the devices. So with the help of these type of network, it is possible to prolong, or it is possible to use the battery life from many months to many years with the low complexity, and it provides the data rate up to maximum of 200 kbps. It is intended to operate with an unlicensed international frequency band, and it is targeted at the center, interactive toys, smart budget, home automation and remote control. So this group also operates on the same frequency range which is license free, that is 2.4 gigahertz frequency ISM band, and they are used to operate for the application like home automation, they are used for remote control application, then interactive toys and sensor network. Now here we can see the comparison between the different standards of wireless, and the standards are compared on the basis of frequency, bandwidth, optimum operating range and the point of interest. The three standards are nothing but infrared, Bluetooth and IEEE 802.15 standard. So the IRDA operates on the frequency of 875 nm wavelength, as it uses infrared line, therefore instead of frequency here we are using a wavelength. Bluetooth operates the frequency range of 2.4 GHz. IEEE 802.15 also operates the range of 2.4 GHz, which is a license-free range. Then bandwidth provided by RDA is from 9600 bps up to maximum of 4 Mbps, and in future it can be extended up to 15 Mbps also. The bandwidth provided by version 1.1 of Bluetooth is of 720 kbps, and for version 2.0 it is 10 Mbps. Similarly, the 802.15.1 provides bandwidth of 1 Mbps, and 802.15.3 provides bandwidth of 20 plus Mbps. Then operating range provided by the standards are nothing but 1 to 2 meters by IRDA, then 10 meters to 100 meters by Bluetooth, and 10 meters up to 100 meters for IEEE 802.15. Now moving toward the point of interest, IRDA requires line of sight for the communication. Without line of sight, it is not possible to perform any data transfer between the two devices which uses the IRDA standard. Then for the Bluetooth, the point of interest are automatic discovery of the device, then communicate through a physical barrier. When we turn on the Bluetooth, it is possible for the Bluetooth device to automatically discover the other devices which are in the nearby range of the Bluetooth. At the same time, if there is any physical barrier, then also the communication is possible. That means it doesn't require line of sight for performing the data communication. Now, moving towards the point of interest of IEEE 802.15 standard is, it uses Bluetooth as a foundation. That means at the time of development of the IEEE 802.15 standard, the researcher know about the Bluetooth features and they uses the some part of the Bluetooth feature for originating 802.15 standard. So it uses basic foundation as a Bluetooth features and coexistence with the 802.11 devices. So on the basis of these parameter, we can differentiate or we can compare the various standards of wireless PAN network. Now let's move on to the advantages of the personal area network or wireless personal area network. So no extra space is required. Personal area network doesn't require any extra wire or any extra space in order to form a communication, as they use this wireless medium as a data transmission medium. For connecting two devices, you only require to enable the Bluetooth in both the device and start sharing the data amongst them if we are using a standard as a Bluetooth standard. For example, connecting wireless keyboard to the mouse with the table through Bluetooth. So simple, a connection between the mouse and connection between the PC, as well as connection between the keyboard and PC, is considered as an example of a simple wireless personal area network which do not require any cable or do not require any extra space for the connection purpose. Then moving towards the second advantage, that connect too many devices at a time. Many devices can be connected at a time. For example, in case of Bluetooth, maximum 8 devices can be connected with each other in order to form a small piconet. If we want to connect more than 8 devices, then 2 piconets can be connected to each other, which forms a scatter net. So there is no limitations that how many devices we want to connect in order to form a personal area network. You can connect one mobile to other mobile or table, tablets, or for sharing of files. Then the next advantage provided by the wireless personal area network is nothing but cost effectiveness. No extra wires are needed, therefore there is a reduction in the cost of cable. At the same time, no extra data charges are involved, so that the PAN is an expensive way of communication. As we use this license-free frequency range, that is 2.4 GHz, therefore there is no need of paying any extra charges for the data communication purpose, and there is no charge of cable to be paid. Therefore, the total cost of the wireless personal area network is very less. The next thing is nothing but the ease of use. It is very easy to develop a network simply by connecting the Bluetooth. It is possible to perform a data transfer between the devices, and no advanced setup is required for the connection purpose. Then the next feature is nothing, or the next advantage is nothing but reliability. If we use this type of data connection within 10 meters, then the network is stable and reliable. The next feature is security. This network is secured because all the devices are authorized before the data sharing. Third party injection and data hacking are not possible in PAN network, because when we perform a data transfer using a wireless PAN network, then most of the time the users know to each other, or if the data transmission is between the keyboard and PC, then it is also known to the user. So we can say the devices which are present in the personal area network are authorized devices and they are known to the user, and therefore the security provided to the data transfer is very high in case of PAN network. The third party effect or the third party attack are not get easily occurred in case of wireless PAN network. Therefore, from security point of view also, the wireless PAN network is more advanced as compared to other types of network. The next advantage is used in the office, conferences, and meeting. The infrared is a technology used in the TV remote, AC remote, and other devices. Bluetooth, infrared, and other types of PAN is used to interconnect the digital devices in the office, meeting, and conferences. For example, the limitation of infrared, that is, it requires a line of sight limitation, is not considered as a practical limitation in some of the offices. In some of the offices, the printer and the computers are connected to each other by using the infrared only. So in the office, or in case of conferences or meeting, we can use infrared as a wireless communication standard, or we can use Bluetooth as a wireless communication standard. Then the next advantage provided by wireless PAN is nothing but synchronized data between different devices. One person can synchronize several devices, that is download, upload, exchanging of data between the devices. Next advantage is nothing but portability. As the devices are portable, that means as there is no restriction on the mobility of the user, therefore it is possible for the user to move anywhere with the help of Bluetooth network or with the help of wireless network. User can move its own device, which is Bluetooth enabled, within an area of the wireless PAN network. PAN is portable as well as. That indicates PAN is also a portable network. Now, apart from the various advantages provided by PAN network, there are some disadvantages which are also provided by PAN network. So let's discuss it. Less distance range. So if we look at the table of comparison between the IRDA, Bluetooth and IEEE 802.15 standard, the range provided by or the coverage area provided by the standard is very less. So basically PAN itself is a short area network. As its name indicates, it's a personal area network. That means it is a very short range network, and that is considered as a disadvantage. The range is from 10 meter and maximum it covers a range up to 100 meter, which makes sharing quite difficult if the user goes beyond 100 meter. Then the second disadvantage is nothing but interference with the radio signal. As it operates on the license free frequency band of 2.4 gigahertz, therefore it may possible that the other electronic equipment which also operates on the same frequency band may cause interference with the data transfer between the devices. For example, a cordless phone or a microwave oven, they also operates at the frequency range of 2.4 gigahertz. Therefore, the magnetron tube used in the microwave oven radiate at the same frequency. So that radiation causes an interference between the data transfer in case of wireless PAN. The next disadvantage is slow data rate. Bluetooth and infrared having slow data rate as compared to the other type of networks. For example, if we compare PAN with LAN and MAN, then definitely the data transfer rate is smaller as compared to LAN and MAN network. Next is nothing but the health problem. Now, in some cases, PAN uses microwave signal in some digital devices which have a bad effect on the human body, like brain and heart problem may occur. So this is considered as a serious or one of the important disadvantages of the PAN network, as it deals with the health of the human body. The next is nothing but costly in terms of communication device. The personal area network is basically formed by using a digital devices which are Bluetooth enabled, and if we consider the mobile phones, which are somehow costlier as compared to other devices, so smartphones, PDA, laptop, digital cameras, these are the costlier devices, and if we want to form a PAN network by using these devices, so somehow it is considered as a costlier option of communication. Next is nothing but infrared signal travels in the straight line. The TV remote uses the infrared signals for having a communication with the TV, so which have a problem as they travel in the straight line. So line of sight is considered as one of the disadvantages of the PAN network in a standard of IRDA. Now, apart from the various advantages and disadvantages, the wireless PAN network finds its application in many of the areas, and few application areas of the wireless network are nothing but wireless keyboard, then wireless mouse, then smartphone, TV remote, wireless printers, then gaming consoles, then smartphone technology, which includes infrared, Bluetooth, FireWire, ZigBee, ultra wideband, wireless USB. So these are considered as some of the applications of the wireless personal area network. As the demand of wireless technology and as the demand of wireless communication is going on, therefore there is a rapid development in the various standards of the wireless personal area network. As it provides a cost-effective solution, as well as it provides a personal space to the user, and it do not restrict mobility of the user. At the same time, it provides a secure communication. Because of this, the wireless communication gaining more and more popularity in the world. And the development is going on in the various standards of the wireless communication, because of which people uses it in more and more form or in some other form in order to develop the various applications. So I hope you understand the topic of introduction to wireless PAN network and need of wireless PAN network. Along with that, we have covered the topic of various standards. The three basic standards are infrared, Bluetooth and IEEE 802.15 standard. They're small introduction about the standard and also the comparison, then advantages, disadvantages of the wireless PAN network and application. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.